Master Kota is dead?
Yes.
His lightsaber. My spies have located another Jedi. Kazdan Paratus is far more powerful than you. I do not expect you to survive. But if you destroy him, you'll be one step closer to your destiny.
The Emperor?
Yes. Only together can we defeat him.
I will not fail you, my master.
Amazing. It looks just like the Jedi Temple on Coruscant.
Proxy, are you picking up any communications?
Too many to decipher. I can hear thousands of droids all calling out to each other. This is where all droids go to die.
Set us down as close to that thing as you can.
I'll do my best. There are not many clearings. You'll need to approach the temple on foot.
Returning to low orbit. Scanners show you'll need to make it through that large hyperdrive core in front of you. Once on the other side, you should be able to reach the junk temple. Good luck.
Hello, everybody, and welcome to part 3 of Star Wars The Force Unleashed. And we're now on Raxus Prime, looking for Jedi Master Kazdan Paratus, and as soon as you begin this level, you actually get the ability to use Force Lightning. That is something we couldn't do in the previous level, and it also unlocks a whole bunch of different combos in the Force Combos list. So right off the bat, I would absolutely recommend getting Sith Slash and Sith Saber Smash in the Combos list, which, by the way, is a really hard tongue twister if you try saying them at the same time over and over again. Sith Slash, Sith Saber Smash, Sith Slash, Sith Saber Smash, Sith Slash, Sith Saber... Yeah, you know, really hard to say, but either way. Like I said, we now have access to Force Lightning. We can now shoot electricity out of our fingertips and fry a whole bunch of enemies with them, just like the Emperor from Return of the Jedi.
You're going to need to find a way to get through that hyperdrive core. Is there anything nearby you could use as a makeshift explosive?
Why, yes, there is. In order to progress to the next area of this level, we actually have to find 3 of the engines and shock them with lightning. So you're gonna have to look out for that, otherwise you're gonna be stuck in this area. And this place has a whole bunch of acid and stuff, but it doesn't insta-kill you.
I'm picking up scraps of Rhodey's communication. You're approaching some sort of salvage operation.
I'll deal with them.
And there's our justification for our new enemies, because the Rebels aren't here. Actually, in this particular time period, the Rebel Alliance isn't a thing yet, I should mention. This game takes place in between Revenge of the Sith and A New Hope, and we're still in that intermediate point where the Empire has just gotten power over the galaxy, Darth Vader is still hunting down Jedis, but we don't really have a Rebel Alliance. We don't have an assembled group of people who are taking the fight to the Empire. What General Rom Koda's group was, that was his own militia. That wasn't part of the Rebel Alliance. And keep watching this game, because we might see more of the beginning of the Rebel Alliance in this very, very game. So, yeah. So we're not going to be finding Rebels here, and we're not going to find Imperials here either, because it's a junkyard. They have no reason to be here. Well, not yet, anyway. And, now we're just fighting a whole bunch of Rhodians, a lot of melee guys with these big scythe weapons that come at you, and mini-gunner Rhodians as well, and we've seen mini-gunners in the last level. So like I said, this acid doesn't kill you in one hit. You can land in it for a little bit. It will gradually take your health away the longer you're in it. But you're encouraged to use the Force to lift these platforms up so you can stand on them and make sure you don't die, because, you know. Well, who wants to walk around in acid? And oh my god! That skiff nearly killed me! And that's, of course, one of the bonus objectives, as you saw on the screen. If you destroy 10 skiffs, we will get a bonus force upgrade. So if you see some skiffs, just shoot some lightning at it, because lightning does wonders, ladies and gentlemen. Lightning is one of the best abilities in Star Wars The Force Unleashed, because anytime you shock somebody, you're not only gradually draining their health, like really little by little, but after you stop using the power, they're actually going to be staying there for at least 2 or 3 seconds going like, because they're all electrified and they're just like reacting to the electricity, right? And that's one of the reasons I wanted to get Sith/Sith Saber Smash, because when you push XYY or XXY, you know, the final hit will always be electricity. It'll always be lightning.
Eclipse to Starkiller. We're picking up a lot of movement beyond that hyperdrive core.
And when you have lightning at the end of your combos, you can, you know, stun them even longer so that you could do another combo to them directly afterwards. Unlimited power! Okay, I have limited power. You can't use Force Lightning forever. The blue energy bar on the top left does go to the left, and you'll have to cool off and get your electricity back, but, you know. I just love frying Jawas, I don't know. They're small, they're really weak, and they're by far the lightest enemies in the game to throw with the Force. You can throw Jawas so friggin' far, so friggin' fast. It's kind of amazing. I love how each enemy has their own kind of weight. Like, when you try lifting, like, a minigun or Rodian, you definitely feel them going through the air a lot slower than, say, a Stormtrooper would. Or, like, you know, a Jawa, where, like, a Jawa could go so far, it's just ridiculous. But, hey, I don't care, man. I'm gonna attack Jawas, because they attack you. They have these little, like, fire spark things that are gonna poke you with, and they have grenades, and those grenades hurt. You can't actually use the Force to pick up grenades and throw them back at enemies, but most of the time I find the camera sort of sends the grenade, like, way up in the sky, and it's a little bit hard to exactly send it where you want them to go, so I always just try to avoid grenades rather than throw them back at them. But you can potentially pick up grenades with the Force and send it back at them, which is kind of a cool feature, you know? Stop attacking me with that blowtorch! You little Jawa bastard. But, you know, again, Sith/Sith Saber Smash are combos I would absolutely recommend getting, because just, you know, having the ability to... Sometimes you can stunlock certain enemies, too. Like, if you activate XXY, and then they're, like, standing there shocked, you can do another combo on them and get extra damage, and it's great. And in general, electricity is just a great weakness-exploiting move where, you know, force pushes are good, but most of the time when you have a bigger enemy, it's not going to knock them over, you know? It's just going to, like, sort of deal them a little bit of damage, but not really do anything to them. And when you get, like, force repulse and stuff later, it's great, don't get me wrong, but it doesn't deliver consistent, constant damage like lightning does. When you get, like, an upgraded lightning with upgraded force energy so that you have lots of force energy to burn, you can come up to some of the bigger enemies and just fry and fry and fry and fry and drain their entire health bar without doing anything. It truly is unlimited power, and I love having lightning. What the fuck? Jesus! Team Jawa's blasting off again! That's how light they are. I sent him into another planet! I sent him into outer space! That's how light Jawas are! You can use the Force for puzzle things occasionally. Right now, there's lots of sparks that'll rain down on you and drain your health, but if you use the Force to move these platforms over it, it won't rain on you and you'll be perfectly fine. You won't get any sparks in your hair.
Juno, I'm not sure what I'm looking at here. Are you picking up anything?
Just some panic transmissions. The scavengers didn't expect any droid resistance.
So now we're coming up to another enemy type of the game, and these are the Force Robots. Yes, apparently Kazdan Paradis is so strong in the Force, he actually can make robots out of all the junkyard scrap metal and make them adept with, like, bow staffs and, like, attack you with them and... Oh god, oh god, oh god! I almost fell into that goop. Like I said before, the previous area, the acid won't kill you in one hit, but there's a lot of parts in Force Unleashed that doesn't really know... It's not really consistent with what triggers as a bottomless pit. Like, that would have been bottomless pit territory. Like, at some point, you just fall a certain distance, and then the game just drains your health, and then Starkiller goes limp and ragdoll, and he just decides, like, oh, I'm dead, because this is a bottomless pit. And so, again, bottomless pits you gotta watch out for. I mean, the good news is you don't have a live system in Force Unleashed. You don't have to worry about, oh, you lost all your lives. Now you have to redo a level all over again. No. You have unlimited lives. You'll just go back to a previous checkpoint. You're never going to be... Even if you turn off the game and stuff, like, if I'm somewhat far in Raxus Prime, but I have to, like, go somewhere, like, I got a phone call. Oh, man, my mother needs me to get her some medicine or something. If you turn off the game, you will still be at the exact checkpoint that you saved the game at when you resume, which I appreciate, you know. Because sometimes when you have levels that go on for, like, a half hour, 30 minutes, you don't want to be, like... Oh man, I'm like 20 minutes in, but now I gotta stop, and I don't want to have to do those 20 minutes again. Luckily, the checkpoint system in Force Unleashed is really nice, really generous, and I appreciate that, you know? As always, whenever you see something that's tinted blue, you could probably move it with the Force. Or, like in this instance, there's something tinted blue, but you don't use the Force. You use lightning to burst it open. A little conflicting. Sometimes you see it, you're like, oh, it's blue, I must be able to move it with the Force. Sometimes you have to use Force pushes, sometimes you have to use lightning. The general gist is, hey, your Force powers can do something to this, so try using something on it. Oh, you minigunners.
How strange. The scanners aren't picking up any power signatures from those droids. It's as if they're being powered by...
the Force.
So yeah, getting back to that topic, these robots are powered by the Force. Kazdan Paradis, this Jedi Master we're coming down to kill, I guess one of the reasons he wasn't killed during Order 66 is because he can make scrap metal be his soldiers, and adept with bow staffs. these robots are pretty much designed for the Force lightning.
Eclipse to Starkiller. Watch your step. Readouts are showing a massive river of toxic hyperdrive plasma nearby.
I copy.
You'll need to find a way into the scavengers camp nearby. Head through the bottom of that blockade runner.
Because, like, this is the first level you get introduced to the Force lightning, right? So, you just use Force Lightning on these robots, and I killed that guy just with lightning. And keep in mind, my Force Lightning is not upgraded to the max. I don't have the most Force energy I could possibly have. You can usually just use a full bar of mana, full bar of Force, to lightning a robot, and it will die no problem, which I always appreciate, because this whole level is about introducing the lightning. It's how you take out the skiffs, it's how you activate the engines to burst open the wall. They really want you to use lightning, and I promise you, the boss coming up, Kazdan Paradis, he's pretty susceptible to lightning, too. Hey, Jawa. How you doing? Bye! I don't care, man. I don't care how light they are. They're in my way. And that is a loading transition. Keep in mind, for Force Unleashed, in order to make this playthrough go by a lot quicker, I'm actually editing out a lot of load times. I'm actually adding out load times in pause menus, too, because one of the problems with Force Unleashed, it's not a huge deal, it's not like we're talking, I don't know, Skyrim levels of load times, or Star Wars Knights of the Old Republic levels of load times, at least on the Xbox, not so much the PC, because I'm sure with the PC the load times are super fast, but in the Xbox 360 version of The Force Unleashed, and probably the PS3 version, I've never played the PS3 version. When you have to go into your Force upgrades list, or your lightsaber list, or your costumes list, it does take at least 8 or 9 seconds in order to get into that. So what you're seeing is me editing that stuff out every time I go to the pause menu. Like, every time I go to the pause menu, I just instantly get to what I'm trying to select. Who the hell made that door? And by the way, I'm not locked in here with you, you're locked in here with me. Because I'm badass McEdgerston Starkiller. Actually, I don't even think Starkiller's that edgy of a Star Wars character. I mean, he is raised in the dark side, he is Darth Vader's secret apprentice, he has been raised all his life to use Force Lightning and kill Jedis and stuff, and he's been trained to be a bad apple. He's been trained to have hates in his life, you know. But he's still kind of, like, young and still kind of like a child and naive at many points in the game. He still has a robot friend, Proxy. He still gets along with that guy. And he saw Juno in the first part of this game, and he's like, oh my god, who's that? It's a girl! I'm not a bully! I am not a bully! They're in my way, they throw grenades at me. People who throw grenades at me are bullies, okay? I mean, did Yoda not teach us one thing? Size matters not. Judge me by my size, do you? I judge that Jawa not by his size, but by the fact he has grenades and he tries to kill me with his blowtorch. That tells me that I'm not a bully. I am simply defending myself. Okay? I am simply defending myself. This is an Undertale, okay? I'm not gonna get awesome bonus ending for leaving everybody alive. They're trying to kill me, man! They're trying to kill me. you may have noticed, before I threw that Jawa and got the bully achievement, I did pick up a gold lightsaber crystal, which is different from yellow. Like, in the first level, I picked up yellow. And in this level, I picked up gold. So, it's a little bit more... I mean, you know the difference between yellow and gold, right? That's all. I don't even know why I have to explain that, but, you know, there's gold-colored, and then there's yellow-colored. So, they do have lightsaber colors in this game that weren't in the movies. I don't remember yellow and gold ever being in the movies. There's one color in the very last level of the game that I certainly don't remember in any other video games or any other movies. And, it's quite the color, let me tell you. But, I love throwing guys. I just love seeing their ragdolls flying in the sky. Like, I'm just imagining the drop and the sudden impact those guys are gonna suffer when they get to their destination, you know? Like, one minute their minigunner's coming at me, and then, whoosh! No! Boom! Dead. So that's how we get rid of the generator. I had to go into this side area, I had to move that machine to the left, and that destroys the generator so I can go back to that big area and go through that area, but, ow! And sometimes you throw them into stuff that are floating in the sky, and I love that too, it's so good. So damn good. But yeah, I would say this level isn't really too bad. Again, the robot force ghost guys, you can handle them with electricity just fine, and if you have Sith Saber Smash, that tongue twister word, you could just do that combo to them to leave them stunned and susceptible to attacks really easily. And again, my big tip for anything, especially when in this scenario right now, I'm surrounded by tons of minigunners. I'm surrounded by a lot of them. And when you're in Sith Lord and Sith Master mode, those kinds of difficulties, again, your health goes down really quick if you let them touch you too much, you know? So I just gotta recommend, like, dash as much as you can, slash everything you can. If something's far away from you, don't try walking up to it most of the time. Use the Force. Pick them up with the Force, chuck them somewhere so that you don't need to walk up to them. These guys can all be lifted with the Force. There are enemies later who can't be lifted up with the Force, but when they're very far away from you and they're shooting at you, use your telekinesis, use your crazy mystical Sith powers, you know? Because we gotta kill those Jedis. Starkiller doesn't know why, he just knows that they're bad people. That he just knows the Empire needs them dead. These things actually drain your Force energy, by the way, these little tiny robots. I killed them too fast for you to see, but they do drain your Force energy if you let them do their thing, so you gotta watch out for that. I also don't think you could Force grip them, or I might be wrong about that. I think they have some kind of protective barrier that stops them from doing that. Maybe that's why I didn't do it, but... in general, I just slash at them and shoot lightning at them, and it seems to go pretty well. Fry, my robot friend, fry! In order to clear a path for me, I gotta shoot this engine with electricity as well. But doing so triggers a certain enemy to appear, and now we're coming up to a mini-boss, the Junk Titan. Again, Kazdan Paradis is quite the Jedi if he's capable of creating something like this from wherever the hell he is, by the way. If he's just in the area where we're gonna fight him, like, how far does his Force energy reach? I'll say this about the Force Unleashed. It can get goddamn ridiculous after a while in terms of how many crazy things that happen in this game and what is capable with the Force. I mean, I'm gonna get to a certain thing coming up in an Imperial Shipyard level involving a big ship that, you know, it's quite the feat. It's quite the feat. It's something you've never seen in any of the movies, but, you know. I've never considered Star Wars The Force Unleashed to be official canon. There's always been this discussion about Star Wars canon, by the way, that's like, well, ever since J.J. Abrams has been making the new movies, everything's non-canon now. Everything's not... It doesn't exist anymore. But to me, it's always been like... Hasn't that always been the case, though? I mean, for me, the movies were the only thing that were canon, and the video games, the comics, the TV shows, they were all just extensions of that, you know? They were all just extensions to make Star Wars fans happy. But I think, like, the only things that ever really should matter are the movies, whether you like the prequels or not. I'll try spinning! That's a good trick! Whether you like the prequels or not, those are canon, you know? Like, even today, they're still canon. And, like... Okay, so I don't consider Force Unleashed all that canon. You know, it gets pretty ridiculous, especially in regards to a lot of the origin stories going on in this game that you'll see later. But it's still a fun game to play. I still like all the actors involved. I like all the plot arcs, and I like the game in general. I think it's a fantastic game to play. I do like how the game's constantly changing it up with every single level. You know, it never feels like the same game... throughout the whole entire thing. You always feel like you're doing something different in every level, which I really appreciate. And I don't really consider it canon, but, you know, it's still a fun game, and I don't care if Knights of the Old Republic ain't canon anymore. I don't care if Rogue Squadron 2 on the GameCube's not canon anymore. You know, I don't care. These games are still going to be special to me. They're still going to exist, you know. You had a similar thing with J.J. Abrams with the Star Trek movies, where people were like, oh, man... Star Trek erased the planet Vulcan, and it erased the entire continuity of Star Trek. Now Captain Kirk is a different Captain Kirk and stuff, and it's like, the old TV show is not gone. You can still watch that. It's still there for you, you know? You can consider the J.J. Abrams movies to be non-canon. It doesn't matter. Shit. Shadows of the Empire can still be canon to me. I don't care. Nothing about Force Awakens contradicts it yet, you know? I haven't seen anything about the new movies that is like, no, Dash Rendar is totally not a character who doesn't exist, you know? I don't know why I'm going to this big spiel about canon, but, you know, I just wanted to say, I don't care. I've never cared about canon. I don't see the obsession with canon. What counts is what counts, goddammit. It's all in your head. What counts to you is what counts to you. Anywho, I have to collect this holocron over here, but it's surrounded by this big, gaping, bottomless pit. And in order to get to the holocron, I have to move these metal structures, I have to extend them so that they're platforms. And they're really unsteady platforms, too. They're really, like, glitchy and, like, you try landing on them and, like, your character shakes so much, it's kind of ridiculous. I think it's, yeah, right here. Thing just keeps shaking. Oh, God. But this is where you realize that, like, the platforming in Force Unleashed is not perfect, and sometimes you really gotta get used to air dashing to a wall in which the platform is connected. That's my biggest tip. Air dash to a wall that the platform is connected to. But either way, ladies and gentlemen, that holocron was a bonus costume. We just got ourselves the Sith robe. This is a costume you can completely miss out on. You'll never wear unless you find that particular holocron. And you can put it on whenever you want. And so, this is the Sith robe. It's actually pretty badass. I really like this costume because this is one of the coolest Sith outfits you can have in Star Wars The Force Unleashed. And, again, in 2008, we didn't have a Kylo Ren. We didn't have a Force Awakens or any of the new movies coming out. So, if you want to imagine your Kylo Ren, this is the closest you'll get to a Kylo Ren-type costume. Because it's just this black outfit with black hood and... a little bit of a metal plating on the front, but I like it. I like it a lot. I think this is also the teaser outfit that was in the teaser trailer for Star Wars The Force Unleashed, because in the teaser trailer, I don't want to reveal what happens, but a Sith does something to a ship And I think the Sith was wearing this outfit. I think this was the teaser outfit. So, you know, it's a badass outfit. It makes you look badass, and I enjoy it quite a bit. You do not want to miss out on that holocron. Anyway, folks, this is the Junk Titan. We have already killed one, but I figure I'll talk about him now. He just put his rock arm, his molten rock arm, into the ground, and it would actually create fire wherever you were standing. So I had to jump out of the way as soon as he did that, because apparently Junk Titans are capable of that. Again, it's a video game. Roll with me. Somehow, I don't believe Han Solo or Luke Skywalker could probably fight this thing in any of the movies, but whatever. This thing is really susceptible to lightning. You could throw things at him to deal out mega damage. I would just recommend staying a fair distance away from him, shoot lightning, throw objects at him. If he puts his fist to the ground, he's going to shoot fire underneath you. Just jump out of the way every time that happens. He's big, he looks intimidating, but he's not really all that hard to deal with if you know what to do. And here we have an AT-ST machine. You know, without the legs. Is it AT-ST or is it AT-ST? I know some people like to call them AT-ATs. Do you call it AT-AT or do you call it AT-ATs? AT-STs? AT-ST? Is it an AT-ST? Either way, it's boss time. Let's take on that Jedi.
Cast Imperatus at last.
Don't worry, Masters. I'll defend you from this Sith trash.
Also, all the cutscenes in the game are pre-rendered. They load up instantly, so because there's no load screen, they're FMV clips. And so whatever costume you're wearing, that's not going to be the costume reflected in the cutscenes. So I had the Sith robe on, but obviously he was still wearing his Junker gear. But, you know, whatever. Kazdan Paradis is kind of interesting because he's basically this Jedi who's gone, like, crazy. He's made this Jedi temple out of the junkyard of Raxus Prime, and he's actually made junk sculptures of, like, Yoda, Ki Adi Amundi, Mace Windu, Obi-Wan Kenobi, and stuff. And it's weird because you're fighting him in some sort of makeshift Jedi council room. But it's obviously delusional, because Kazdan is just crazy, and he's lost his mind after being in hiding for so long. And you always wonder, like, why didn't that happen to, like, Yoda when he was on Dagobah? Like, Yoda could have easily lost his mind just being living in a swamp for, like, 20 years or so, but, you know. Either way, this guy's not good at blocking lightning, so I'd recommend doing that a lot. You can actually throw the scrap Jedis that are sitting in the chairs at him. But, you know, sometimes he always gets a lot of hits on you otherwise, and that can be a little bit dangerous. When you're losing health, he does... Well, not when you're losing health. When he loses health, he'll eventually start spawning some Junk Titans to fight you. But if you yourself are losing health, you can refill your health by taking out these Junk Titans. And it's a great way to stunlock them. Like I said, Sith Slash, Sith Saber Smash are great, because when you activate that combo on a Junk Robot... They get stunned. They stand there going like, oh, da, 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 da. And then you can hit them again, and 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 just keep dealing out damage like that. So I actually managed to keep him stuck in place and keep electrifying him, and it's great. After he summons a Junk Titan, he's usually going to send these pieces of objects that are floating around the temple at you, and you have to pick up the objects with the Force and throw them back at him. Now, I will say this, the lock-on on Force Unleashed is not perfect. Sometimes it can be a little bit wonky. You can only pick up things when there's a cursor on it. Like, if you don't see a blue hitbox on something, you can't trigger the right trigger to activate and grab it, you know? And that occurs with lightning as well. If you see an enemy and they don't have a blue hitbox on them, you're going to activate lightning, but you're just going to spray lightning in front of yourself, and you're not going to be spraying it on the enemy. So, sometimes the hitbox can be wonky. Sometimes I feel like, oh, this enemy's throwing something at me, and I need to pick up those objects and throw them back at him. But the hitbox isn't showing up, and it's coming at me, and I can't do anything, and oh, it hit me, you know. And that's just one of the issues of Force Unleashed. It's very much like the Sonic series and the way their hitbox works is... Hitboxes work for something like Sonic the Hedgehog, you know, with the homing attack and stuff in Sonic. But Again, Force Unleashed is not a perfect game. I think it has some spotty platforming elements every now and then. I wish the hitbox was a lot more consistent. I wish it worked 100% of the time. Sometimes it works like 85% of the time. Every now and then the hitbox does not activate when you're trying to grab something. Like right there. That's why I brought it up. He threw something at me, and there's a hitbox, but the first time he did, I didn't have a hitbox. Where's my hitbox? It hit me a second time because I couldn't see a hitbox. Oh, third time, you know? Sometimes the hitbox just doesn't show up, and then when you can't pick up something because there's no hitbox, you're just standing there looking like a dumbass. Like, I wasn't... I would have dodged it if I knew I couldn't pick it up, but obviously I thought I was going to pick it up, so... I couldn't look badass, you know? And that makes me uncomfortable, not looking badass in front of the internet. I'm wearing these Sith robes and everything, Kasdan! I'm a badass Sith master, and you made me look like an idiot! Either way, that's the boss fight. Just keep hitting him with lightning, keep doing stuff to him. And this is what I was talking about earlier in part one, how you can't lose boss QTEs. Doesn't drain my health, doesn't cost me a life, he'll just keep doing this over and over and over again until I eventually activate it and do it correctly.
Juno, I'm done here.
I'll probably make a bonus video showing all the QuickTime event fails, because some of them are pretty hilarious. The next boss coming up can keep slashing you with their lightsaber over and over and over again, and Starkiller keeps falling down like a dumbass, but he never loses health, he never dies, and it's kind of ridiculous. Either way, folks, we will report to Darth Vader about our success in part 4. See you then.